and figure out how this works, right? Like a 2-minute primer on, like, why do you do continuous delivery in the first place? Basically to get fast feedback and release frequently so that you can get fast feedback. This is also to reduce the risk of releasing itself. Like if you back up a bunch of stuff, release once in 6 months, you're carrying a lot of risk in like the types of things you develop itself, like business features, are they useful and that kind of stuff. Plus technical risk also, like will this deploy properly, will this fail, are there bugs and that kind of stuff, like integration risk and things like that. So reduce risk, you basically release frequently and you have reduced the risk. There's also this learning and responding to customer needs. Like business is changing so fast nowadays. If you don't have something in the market to like counteract what the competitors are putting out in the market, like maybe you are at a big loss. And if you have like a 6-month cycle and the customer your competitors have something in the market, you are basically like giving them 6 months to like get more customers and stuff, and then you are behind. So if you are releasing frequently, you can catch up to them faster, counteract that competitive force much faster. So